Time now for our Sunday morning Q&A. Joining us this morning is Dr. Oxiris Barbot, the Commissioner for Health for Baltimore City. Good morning.
Good morning, Lisa.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Well, you were with me in an important story that we had on earlier this week on the health profiles for Baltimore City. Tell me about those health profiles. What were you trying to do there?
So the health profiles are our way of showing all communities what their health status is, because sometimes what happens when we talk about general health status for Baltimore mm-hmm. City, people think, oh, that doesn't apply to me. And so by looking at neighborhood health specific data, people can see, oh, this is the rate of obesity in my community, this is the number of supermarkets, corner stores that we have, and it becomes more real.
And over again, in some of the neighborhoods that are not, that are at the bottom when it comes to the profiles, you see a density of alcohol, stores that sell alcohol and tobacco, and a lack of healthy food options?
What we have found is that in the neighborhoods that have the greatest concentration of things that don't contribute to good health, such as the ones that you measure, mm-hmm. There is a concentration of those, and it affects the overall health in terms of premature death from heart disease, premature death from stroke, diabetes, and those kinds of health issues.
What were some, if you get off the top of your head, some of the better the examples of neighborhoods that were at the top of the health profile picture?
Well, some of the neighborhoods that had some of the best health outcomes were actually distributed throughout the city. Mm-hmm. And the good thing is that what we found was that most neighborhoods had some good, solid health indicators from which to build, right? So not all neighborhoods had all negative indicators. So for example, some neighborhoods with high premature death from heart disease also had somewhat better access to supermarkets. They may have had lower density of corner stores, you know, having better access to healthy foods. And so it gives us something from which to build.
But did you also find, and I think in looking at some of the data, what I saw is that in neighborhoods where the life expectancy was higher, so was the income. So money has a lot to do with this.
Absolutely. What we find is that the best indicators of good health outcomes are higher income, higher levels of education. And so that's why in the profiles we include the overall percentage of individuals with college degrees, the percentage of kids that go into kindergarten ready to learn, because those are important measures for long-term good health outcomes.
So what do you do with all of this information?
So what we're doing is we're having neighborhood meetings throughout the city. So far we've had 5 of them, and we have another 8 to go. And what we want to do is engage communities in understanding what are the priorities in their health, in their neighborhoods. How can we get people to organize around these issues? One of the things that struck me the most in the neighborhoods that we've been to is that there seem to be 3 overriding priorities for communities. One is the recognition of the risks for heart disease. The other one is a recognition that HIV, while we think about it in being certain neighborhoods, certain populations, actually affects all neighborhoods. Mm-hmm. And then lastly, there is organization around the concern regarding liquor outlet density. So all communities, whether they have high density and are looking to reduce it, or whether they have low density of liquor outlets and are looking to maintain it, identify that as an issue.
So it gives them some concrete information to take to, for example, the city council members and say, we want to look at the zoning for liquor stores in this neighborhood.
Absolutely. And so that's what we want people to do, is use this data for action, whether it be to write grants to help support their mm-hmm. community, to advocate to city council or the state. We want this data to be used.
All right. And people can find this data by going to our website, WBALTV.com, but they can also go to Baltimore City.
BaltimoreHealth.org. I would also ask them to go and check out when their community health profiles are being presented, because we want people to come out.
All right. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you, Lisa.
Well, next week our guest will be Maryland Attorney General Doug Gansler. If you have a question for the Attorney General, send that question in. You can email your questions to sundayquestions@WBALTV.com. You can also post your questions to our Facebook page. Don't go